Hey guys, what's up? My name is Sonali. Today I'm going to be filming my October favorites. I'm low-key happy that October flew by because November is my birthday month. I turned 22 on November 25th, so I'm definitely excited about that, but I need you guys to hold me accountable, and if I make my caption that Taylor Swift song that's like, I'm feeling 22, then you can just slap me in the face because I need to be more creative than that, so. I'm pretty sure the last time I did a favorites video was my summer favorites, so that was kind of a while ago, but it's weird because I feel like I cannot think of much to put in this video, but I mean, I have a good handful of stuff, so let's get started. So the first favorite I have is this super comfy, super trendy star little sweater. It's honestly kind of thin. It was actually a PJ set, so it came with matching PJ bottoms. I actually bought the whole set just to wear the shirt because I feel like you could wear that with like leggings and stuff like that. Even though it's a PJ shirt, I'm definitely gonna wear it way more than just going to sleep. I will have the link down below to all these products, so if you guys are interested in checking them out, check the description below. The next favorite that I have is this belt bag, and I know these are super trendy. Of course, the Gucci ones are like the originals and they're so cute, but right now I'm not trying to spend my money on that, so I just got this one from, I think it was Boohoo or Nasty Gal. Like I said, the link will be in the description. I do wish that it was a little bit bigger, like the Gucci ones. They're pretty good size. But this would just hold like a phone, maybe some cards. If you don't really want to carry around a big purse and don't have that much stuff to carry, then I feel like this is really cute. And also it definitely adds to your outfit. My next favorite is this Hemp's body lotion. I have it in the Tahitian vanilla and ginger scent. And my dad used to have like ginger soap, and I would literally wash my hands just to smell the soap on my hands, which is kind of weird, but it was such a good smell that I just had to get this body lotion. And I've actually been eyeing the Hemp's body lotion because I tried it out at Ulta one day and it was so moisturizing, but it is kind of not super cheap. Like I think it was $27, I'm not really sure, but I mean, you can always use your 20% off coupon code that you get in your emails. The next product is the Fenty foundation, and I tried this out last year during tailgate season. I vividly remember filming a Get Ready With Me before game day, and I don't know, I feel like the first time I used it, I wasn't super impressed, but now that I have used other foundations and I'm actually starting to see like the differences in foundations. I got a tan this summer, so I pulled this one back out to use, and it is incredibly matte, but it doesn't make you feel like you're super dry. Right now I'm wearing the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte, and this foundation, like, it kind of like hurts because I feel like I can't move my face because it's so dry, but I feel like this one is matte and it doesn't feel that way. Unfortunately, right now this color is like a little bit too orange for me, so I'm trying to like mix it in with lighter foundations, but I definitely do want to maybe get another color in this one because it honestly makes my skin look so good throughout the day. So for this month's lip product, I wanted to share this little guy. It's from NYX and it is the Plush gel lipstick, and it's in the color Breakup / Rupture. It's honestly the most perfect color for me because I always struggle with finding the right lipstick that's the perfect amount of pink and the perfect amount of brown, and this one is just the best mix. Usually I can't wear too pinky of a lipstick, but this has like that brown undertone mixed with the pink that makes it so perfect for my skin color. I'm currently wearing it right now mixed with a little bit of a darker lipstick, but overall this is what it would look like. It's just this beautiful mauve color. Next up, I have an eyeshadow palette, and this is the Sephora Pro palette, and these colors are first of all amazing, and the color payoff, the pigmentation, and how well they blend, all of it is just incredible. I feel like I've never had an eyeshadow palette like this because I don't really spend too much on eyeshadow palettes. Usually I just get Morphe, but for this one I was willing to splurge because it has every color that I would ever wish for. It even has like that yellow shade that's super trendy, so I really recommend this palette. It is kind of expensive, but it is so worth it because the eyeshadows are unreal. Next, I wanted to share with you guys my most life-changing product, and it is the resurfacing liquid from First Aid Beauty. The last time I went in for a facial, I asked the lady what does she recommend for scarring, because I'm very bad at not picking pimples and I get scars the next day, and she recommended vitamin C. I'm pretty sure it's vitamin C. I think so. And I went to Sephora right after that and got this product because I was recommended it by the Sephora ladies. I use this every single night after I wash my face, and it is insane how fast it breaks up the dark pigmentation and gets rid of acne scarring. So I highly recommend this product, or just vitamin C in general. I know I just tried a sample from Sephora for the Luna oil from Sunday Riley, and I know that's way more expensive, but I feel like I'm willing to splurge for skincare because I like my skin to be nice and beautiful and glowing. So I actually loved how that product felt. So once I finish this, I think I'm gonna get the Luna oil because I'm pretty sure it has vitamin C in it too. So my last favorite of October is a podcast slash video series. It is called Drink with James. If you guys are an influencer, you probably have heard of Four. It used to be Four Card, but now I think it's just Four. And basically, I think it's like the CEO of that company. And so he talks about a lot of like Instagram strategies and branding and stuff about influencers. So I think it's very, very interesting, especially to hear like a CEO of like an influencer and brand company, like his perspective on everything. So I really enjoy listening to that. I usually just watch the YouTube videos because I'm more of a YouTube gal, but I'm 99% sure that he does record podcasts while he records the videos. At least that's what I heard the last time I watched the videos. So if you guys are on the way to work or school one day, I definitely recommend listening to that podcast. So that's it of my October favorites. If you guys are interested in any of these products, I will have the links in the description box below, so go check them out down there. I will see y'all in my next video. Bye!